You knew they had run away from the start.
Yes, I knew.
Why didn't you tell me? Wasted my time.
Say I had. Say I'd said I had troubles. Couldn't control my wife, my daughter. What kind of flaccid prick would you take me for?
Tell me everything you remember about the day they fled. The truth this time.
I'd been soaking myself 3 days straight. Anna came to me, said they were leaving. I begged them to stay. She refused to hear it. I tried to stop her. She wriggled like an eel. We struggled. She fell. Last blasted thing I remember. Woke up in the morn, breeches heavy with my own piss. A large bump on my head. Sadly, they were gone. Know what that's like, Witcher? No. How the fuck could you? I was left with nothing. Nothing! Only the bottle.
Tamara present for all this? She see you quarrel?
Through the doorway, perhaps. She didn't enter the room. Shame, too. Things might have turned out differently. The sight of her always calmed me.
Signs of a fight in the room. Hole in the wall, wine all over the landing. Was that you?
Aye. We tussled. She tried to whack me on the noggin with a candlestick, but kept missing. Hit the wall and a pillar instead. I staggered backwards onto the table. Spilled the wine, slipped and tumbled. Anna used that moment to flee. She rushed down the stairs, still clutching that damn candlestick. I caught her on the landing. We fell. I thought I had her. Then she turned and smacked me in the head. I blacked out. Don't know what happened next. When I came to, I was alone.
What happened next?
Next? It only got worse. I awoke at sunset, not knowing how many days had passed. Thought it was all a ploughing, drunken nightmare. And then I went to the bedchamber, and Anna was not there. Instead, there was blood everywhere. I knew she'd miscarried. My breath short, my throat locked. I neared the bed and saw it. It lay there, a tiny thing, defenseless, on bloodied sheets, dead. And it was my doing.
Maybe you're doing, maybe not. But that amulet she wore could be important, or maybe the fact that she lost it. What did you do with the child?
What was I to do? Took it out and buried it.
Just like that?
Damn you! I gave no thought to a funeral. It was a horror. I wanted it to end. That child had been my dream. I told Anna, the little one, our little one, to make things right. Yet she died before she could be born. Understand, Witcher. My child was dead.
Get hold of yourself. Men like you, when they break down, look downright pathetic.
You're a heartless bastard.
Mutations worked then. But here's the good news. Your dead child might help us find the one who's still alive. And your wife.
What? How?
Sometimes miscarried fetuses, if they don't get a proper burial, turn into botchlings.
Into fucking what?
A cursed creature that draws strength from killing pregnant women. Once it's strong enough, it attacks those who scorned it.
But how? How does it know?
Blood ties. They're a strong bond. A bond I want to use to find your family.
How?
One of two ways. Legends claim you can bury a botchling under the family's threshold, perform a ritual, and turn it into a lubberkin. That's a sort of, hob, a guardian spirit that could lead me to your family.
And the other way?
We kill it and draw some blood. Take that to the Peller and he does the rest.
Do not kill my child. It's suffered enough already. Lift the curse that it may finally rest in peace.
Whatever we do, we gotta find the botchling first.
I'll show you where I buried her, and I'll dig the grave at my threshold.
If it turns out we can't transform the botchling into a lubberkin, they can bury us in it. Handy either way. Need to tend to something first.
Be quick. And me? What am I to do in the meantime?
Sober up.
Witcher, it is as though the heavens sent ye.
Could use some hair of the hound. Got any vodka?
How may I assist you?
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. So long.
How can I help you?
What are you selling? What's good? Take care now.
How may I assist you?
Need some armor. So long.
Come on. That's it, Roach.
Halt! Stand and duel! I challenge you!
Boots a bit big, maybe? Careful not to trip.
Halt, I say! I am Rondvid of the Small Marsh, bound by a sacred oath.
Oh, that's rough. My sympathies.
To honor Maid Bilberry, fairest of all maids I know, by dueling 100 knights to the death. Now, draw your sword post-haste, for I've 99 left after you.
Why are you challenging me? Don't recall doing anything to offend the Maid Bilberry.
Well, why? Then swear. Swear Maid Bilbury's the most loveliest of all.
Thing is, I've never laid eyes on her.
Aha! Ah! I shall wash your scorn away with thy blood fiend! Stand and fight!
Shut up and fight.
No! I yield.
Had enough?
Yes. Luck stood with you. But the next time we meet...
Challenge me again. Raise your hand, draw your sword, look at me the wrong way, and I'll kill you.
You so sure of that?
Yes.
We shall see.
Whoa!
key's gotta be here somewhere.
Kill him, strip him, then dump him in a ditch.
Ah!
Oh, shit! Oh.
Come on, come closer.
Don't regret your mum ever squirting you out.
What? Lost your nerve?
Your life is mine now.
Thank you, Witcher. You ought to come by Mulberry Dale, see me forge. I'll have something for you. A gesture of gratitude.
This is Yondrain Ibn Makir.
Go, go.
I'll whip off your melon and shit down your neck!
Rippy soda!
Come on, come closer.
You're dead!
Your ass is mine.
Faster.
Where'd you come from?
Ice encased his armor. Like winter on a glass pane, his eyes red, like embers in a fire. He leaned o'er me and whispered,
"Boo!"
Trusty arms for all sorts. Steel swords and strong maces for the menfolk, engraved knuckle dusters for the ladies.
Master quality weapons. You capable of making them?
Who do you think I am? A Tory?
A Tory?
The master craftsman of Novigrad. Why, everyone's heard of him. Says he's retired now, so no. Ain't no one can do what you ask.
Show me your wares.